السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم أما بعد أيها الإخوة الأفاضل أيها الأخوات الكريمات أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا اليوم المبارك أن ينضر هذه الوجوه المتوضئة وأن يتقبلني وإياكم في الصالحين وأن يغفر لي ولكم يا رب العالمين ولأمواتنا جميعا وأموات المسلمين برحمته فهو أرحم الراحمين اللهم آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters in Islam, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Muslims, we have to practice our Islam and we have to look to our faith and our Iman. As Muslims, guard your Salah, read your Quran, make your Adhkar, come near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, close to Allah azza wa jal. More good deeds you are doing, more you are solving your problems. But if you are in big problem, hardship, calamities, problems, because of your good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. And this is my hadith today. I am sure some of you heard that hadith that three people they were traveling and it was night time, rain, cold, And they come to with the idea, they found a cave, they said, let's stay at night, stay sometimes at night, just from this rain to stay in the cave until the rain stopped and we'll find a solution for that. While they are inside the cave, what happened? Big rock was falling. Subhanallah, from above the mountain was blocking completely the door of the cave. They stayed where? In the grave. The cave became a grave for them. That's it. No way. They cannot get out. The cave very small, dark, cold, night, and now it's blocked, completely locked. There is no way they can get out. Death, dying. They said, let's come. Who said that? Rasulullah. He's telling us this hadith. And Rasulullah, وَمَا يَنْتُقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. If Rasulullah say something, that's it, done. Yes. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us the story to take the ibrah, the sabak, to take the lesson from that story. One of them, he said, let us, guys, let us invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by our good deeds. I am sure, me and you, subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, somehow we make some good deeds for the sake of Allah one day. If you are in hardship, just remember that good deed and say, Ya Rab, I make this good for your pleasure, your sake. Please, if you know that I make it for your sake, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, for seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help me. If you are in problem or in hardship. And this is what happened. First one of them, he said, كَانَ لِي, told me the hadith, كَانَ لِي وَالِدَان. Subhanallah. And according to the hadith, he said, شيخان كبيران وكنت لا أغبق قبلهما أهلا ولا مالا يعني لا أقدم على أبي وأمي أهلي ولا مالي ولا أولادي. One of them said, يا رب, you know that I had my parents, they were very old age, my dad and my mom. And when I come from work every night, I used to serve them, feeding them by my hand every day. And I cannot eat and my children until I feed my parents. They were old. Nowadays, they are sending their parents to the nursing home. Why? Because for the pleasure of his wife. Subhanallah, he's mistreating his parents. Nowadays, not just that, shouting. Subhanallah, cussing, saying bad words to his parents. Disrespecting, mistreating them. Subhanallah, wallahi, in the news, somebody killed his parents. Yes, subhanallah. Look at the hadith. He said, I cannot feed my wife and my kids until I feed my parents with my hand. Subhanallah, I cannot sleep without doing that. What happened? One night, he said, I came late from my work. I forget completely about them. That's happened. And I came late, they were sleeping. I get the milk and the food. I was standing all the night beside their head while they are sleeping until Salat al-Fajr. Until Salat al-Fajr, they wake up. I did not wake them up. They wake up and I was feeding them until they were satisfied. Ya Rab, if you know, I make this for the seeking your pleasure. Farrij anna ma nahna fi. Ya Rab, help us. And subhanAllah, the rock was moving a little bit. It was not enough for them to get out. But it was moving a little bit. Allah accepted what he said. Sometimes you have to do that. Ya Rabbi, I invoke you by my good deeds. Do that. Let them learn. Second one, he said, كان لي ابنة عم. I had my cousin. I used to love her so much. I was trying to seduce her somehow, and she used to refuse. فألمت بها سنة. She was very poor one time, and her dad died, and she was in need. And somehow I told her, I will give you 120 dinar, golden dinar. Just let me do al-fahisha with you. While I was ready to do it, and she told me, Taqillah. She told me, fear Allah. The lady told me. She reminded him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَفُضَّ الْخَاتَمْ إِلَّا بِحَقِّهِ. And when she reminded me by Allah, I stopped. I gave her all the money I gave. He was a good man. He was not bad. Shaitan was playing in his mind. But when she reminded him by Allah, he stopped. He stopped and he left. Ya Rab, if I, you know, I made this for your pleasure, your sake, فرج عنا ما نحن فيه. Ya Rab, help us. And the rock was moving a little bit. Subhanallah. They were not able to get out. The third one said, Ya Allah, I was hiring someone to work for me, rich man. And these people, all of them, they take in the end of the day their wages, their money, because of the work. And one of them who was debating with me, he said, no, this is not too much for me. I told him, this is enough, not too much. And he was mad and he left the money. And he left, subhanAllah. Years after years after years, I found that man is coming back to ask me for his wages. After years, I told him, man, do you know these cows, these sheep, these girls, all of these for you, and some servants too, slaves, all of these for you. He said, what? Are you making fun of me? Are you kidding me? But I'm asking for my wages, remember? He said, no, I took your money these years and I invested for you. And this is yours. I invested for you. Who can do that? Subhanallah, who can do that? Ya Rab, if you know I made this for your sake, help us, Ya Allah. And the rock was moving completely. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahab, as if I see them, three of them walking out of the cave. Subhanallah. Now we can learn something. First of all, birr al-walidayn. How to respect your parents, especially if they're getting old. Look, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have some hadith for that. The hadith, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, أي العمل أفضل يا رسول الله وأحب إلى الله. What is the most beloved good deeds to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. رسول الله said يا عبد الله الصلاة على وقتها. When you pray five times صلاة daily at night day and night in its fixed time. الصلاة على وقتها especially in the beginning of its time. Some brothers they are praying الحمد لله but the problem is we are delaying our salawat. Maximum, this fatwa from me in America here. Some people, I was I've been invited yesterday to Irvine Masjid yesterday, I was giving lecture. Some people, they make Salat al-Asr 6 o'clock. Salat al-Duhr, Salat al-Asr, the Azan is 4 some. Why you delay to 6 o'clock? Why? This is too much. You know, it's Salat in the beginning of each time. You have to pray. Maximum 20, 30 minutes after the Azan if you make the congregation. Why you delay to this time? You know? This is not good. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. You have to break in the beginning of its time. This is the way. You know, you cannot delay Salah for 2 hours to make the congregation. Yes, I know Salat al-Asr from the Azan of al-Asr to Salat al-Maghrib. This is individually. But Salat al-Jama'ah, I'm talking about the congregation in the Masjid. This one thing. He said the Salatu ala waqtiha, and I told him, Ya Rasulullah, and then, what else? He said after Salah, birru al-walidayn, to respect your parents, to treat them nicely. And what about? This is if they are still alive. You have to respect them, show them respect and love and kindness, especially when they become old. Serve them. They need your service. The way they served you when you were little. The same thing. Also, brothers, what about if they die? You can make dua for them. You can make sadaqah for them. You can make umrah for them. If they did not hajj, make hajj. If you make hajj for yourself first, you can make hajj for them. See, too many ways you can make good deeds for your parents. And subhanAllah, the barakah and the blessings of a righteous kid or son or daughter, subhanAllah, whatever good he is doing, it's going automatically to his parents even if they die. لأن الولد رسول الله said that الولد من كسب أبيه. You are the earnings of your parents. If you make good, that's going back to your mom and your dad in their grave. But if you make something bad, Allah said ولا تزر وزارة وزر أخرى. You know, you're gonna carry your burden yourself. This is the way. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة على وقتها and then بر الوالدين and then الجهاد في سبيل الله. يعني بر الوالدين better than الجهاد في سبيل الله. A man came to Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, I come to you to make an oath or pledge with you for immigration, to migrate with you and to make jihad fi sabilillah, to struggle in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Alaka walidain, do you have parents? Your parents are still alive? He said, yes, ya Rasulullah. He said, fafihima fajahid. Go and struggle, strive to serve them. This is better than jihad fi sabilillah. Your parents, especially your mom. More you serve them, more you get the blessing, the rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man came to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, ارتكبتُ ذنباً عظيماً يا رسول الله. ذنباً عظيماً يا رسول الله. اذنبتُ ذنباً عظيماً يا رسول الله. فهل لي من توبة؟ I did big, big, major sin يا رسول الله. Might be one of the seven deadly sins. سبع الموبقات. I did, يا رسول الله. I committed. I made big, great sin. Is there any توبة, repentance for me, يا رسول الله؟ رسول الله, look this door. ألك أم؟ ألك أم؟ Your mom is still alive. Said, no, يا رسول الله. My mom died. Said, ألك خالة؟ ألك خالة؟ Your aunt is still alive. Because the hadith said that الخالة أم. Your aunt is exactly, she's like your mom. الخالة, your خالة, she's like your mom. This is what Islam said. That's why he said, if you treat her good, your خالة or your أم, your mother, Allah will forgive your sin, even if it is a major, major, major sin. Subhanallah. Away from rahmah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why very important to treat our parents good. Second is, that man, when he was seducing his cousin, and he likes to make al-fahisha, the shameful act, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us in the hadith, من يضمن لي ما بين فكيه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. If you guarantee what's between your jaw, two jaws, your tongue and your private part, not to commit in haram or فاحشة, I guarantee جنة for you. Who said that? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we remember يوسف عليه السلام, the best and good example for us, especially for the youth, not to commit any zina, adultery or haram. We learn from this hadith. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Yusuf alayhi salam, وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهَا عَن نَفْسِهِ وَغَلَّقَتِ الْأَبْوَابَ وَقَالَتْ هَيْتَ لَكْ قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهُ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ إنه لا يفلح الظالمون ولقد همت به وهم بها لولا أن رأى برهان ربه كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين. الله سبحانه وتعالى استند أصل سورة يوسف أحسن القصص. What happened between Yusuf and the wife of Al-Aziz? وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَرَّأَ بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءِ. What is السُّوءِ? مقدمات الزنا. All the ways to adultery, مقدمات. سبحان الله, this is السُّوءِ. What about الفحشاء? الفحشاء is الزنا itself, the adultery itself. السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءَ. Even Yusuf عليه السلام, he did not look for the مقدمات الزنا, the all ways of them. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, عز وجل, in the Holy Quran, وَلَا تَقَرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Don't go near to الزِّنَا. Don't, he did not say, don't commit الزِّنَا. Don't go near to it. Near to it, all ways will lead you to go there. That's why Allah said in Surah An-Nur, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Don't follow the footsteps of shaitan. Why? The footsteps of shaitan will lead you to the haram, to the shameful act. That's why from this hadith we learn, if you will be away from all kinds of haram, shameful acts and stuff like that, the help of Allah Azza wa Jalla will be with you. Also, al-amana, the trust, from the story of the last man, that man when he said, no, I invested your money, I did not eat it in my stomach, and they don't have nothing. Do you have any proof that I owe you money? No. They said, no, I invested for you. Who can do that? Subhanallah. For the sake of Allah, if you do good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. But I will tell you something in the end, brothers, because no time. Subhanallah, they said that what goes around comes around. What goes around comes around. Means, كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانِ كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانِ. Look at this story, subhanallah, during the time of Al-Khalifa Al-Mutawakkil, that Al-Yafi'i, he mentioned that in his book, Mir'at Al-Jinan, he said during the time of Al-Khalifa Al-Mutawakkil, he had a wazir. His wazir, his name was Ibn Zayyat. This man who was zalim, who was not good. When he used to see anybody standing against him, he used to have a box, big box, and that box has nails inside. He used to put him inside into that box. After a while, subhanAllah, he will be wounded from the nails and he will die. And that man, when he was, subhanAllah, about to die, hungry, this is his punishment. He used to tell that Ibn Zayyad, the wazir, arhamni, have mercy on me. قال الرحمة خوار في الطبع. Mercy is weakness. I am not weak. I have to kill you in this way. One time, look, subhanAllah, what happened? Al-Khalifa himself, al-Mutawakkil, he was mad at his wazir. What happened? Khalifa, he was aware about what the wazir is going to do. He puts him inside the box. After 40 days, that man died, Ibn Zayyad. The same way he used to punish people, he died. And he used to tell the Khalifa, al-Mutawakkil, he used to tell him, arhamni, have mercy on me. He said, ar-Rahmatu. He told him the same thing he used to tell people. الرحمة خوار في الطبع. I am not weak to have mercy on you. No, die. The way you punish people. Subhanallah. Look, brothers and sisters. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was migrating with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq from Mecca to Medina secretly, right? What happened to him? سنة الثامنة من الهجرة, 8th of Hijriya. He came back to Mecca with what? 10,000 soldiers, strong. He was going secretly from one of the doors of Mecca. He came and he entered Mecca from all the doors of Mecca. And while he was going out of Mecca, crying, and he was telling Mecca, لولا أن أهلكي أخرجوني منك ما خرجت. Because if it's people, they drove me out of Mecca, I would love to stay all of my life in Mecca. Rasulullah said that. And Allah told him in the Quran, don't cry. إن الذي فرض عليك القرآن لرادك إلى معاد. Indeed, Allah, the one who revealed the Quran to you, Muhammad, will bring you back to Mecca. Don't worry, don't worry, don't cry. And that happened. He's going with weakness, he's coming with 10,000 soldiers. Look, what goes around comes around. Yusuf عليه السلام, what happened to him? His brothers, they sold him with little coins. And subhanAllah, after years, some years, they went to Egypt begging him for help and money and food. أيها العزيز, تصدق علينا إن نراك من المحسنين. Give us sadaqah, food. You are a good man. They sold him with some coins, they came to beg him for food and money. Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, أول من يكسى حلة يوم القيامة. He's the first one when he standing from his grave in the day of judgment, Prophet Ibrahim, Allah will close him because we'll be naked. Sayyidina Ibrahim, even before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you know why? Because one day they throw him into the fire. And the fire makes him naked. That's why Allah will cover him. What goes around comes around. Prophet Ibrahim himself, he was a nation, ummah, because he was carrying all the good attributes of all the nations. Prophet Ibrahim, when you go to Al-Kaaba, Mecca, what happened? You see his footprint. They call it what? Maqam Ibrahim. When you go and make tawaf, you see Maqam Ibrahim there, and you look inside, you're going to see the footprint of Prophet Ibrahim. Did you see any footprint for anybody? When somebody standing above a rock, and that his foot will go into the rock? No, just only Prophet Ibrahim. Why? Because Prophet Ibrahim, his heart was very soft, kind, gentle. ألان الله سبحانه وتعالى له الصخر وألان له قلوب الناس. Allah softened the hearts of people to him and Allah softened the rock for him and his foot was going into the rock. That's why you still have his foot. Why? Because his heart was good, was soft. More you soften your heart, gentle, kind, nice, Allah will soften the hearts of the people, even the rocks for you. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارِ. Dear brothers, dear sisters, as much as you can, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do good deeds as much as you can. Our life is very short. We're going to die, all of us. Whatever you do, this is the only thing you're going to take it with you in your grave. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطئين التوبون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروا. الحمد لله رب العالمين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله للمؤمنين أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers, sisters, fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى as much as you can. Very important as Muslim. Again, I'm going to end the khutbah with what I start. Read your Quran, practice your Islam. Our life is very short. We are going all of us to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Make good deeds. Fill your buckets with good deeds as much as you can when you go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the only thing we're going to take it with us. إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. When the son of Adam dies, his deeds will be cut off except from three things. صدقة جارية, credit for him, charity. As a credit for him, he's doing it, he will get the reward of that in the grave. وعلم ينتفع به, knowledge, you teach it to the people, you spread the knowledge of Islam, making da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وولد, when I say ولد means boy and girl, صالح, righteous boy or girl, they are making du'a for his parents, for his dad and mom. Masjid Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbil Alameen, to forgive all of us. Allahumma maghfir lil muslimin wal muslimat, wal mu'minin wal mu'minat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. لك يا ربي سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اشف من كان منا مريضا, اشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين, وارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين, تب علينا يا ارحم الراحمين. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الابرار. يا ربنا يسر امورنا, يمن كتابنا, واحفظنا جميعا من بين ايدينا ومن خلفنا وعن ايماننا وعن شمائلنا, اجعلنا لك من الشاكرين يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم. وآتكم السلام.
الله أكبر, الله أكبر, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة, حي على الفلاح, قد قامت الصلاة, قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, لا إله إلا الله.
استقيم ورحمه الله في الجبس رسوا اعتدلوا. الله أكبر, الحمد لله رب العالمين, الرحمن الرحيم, مالك يوم الدين, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع يدعون ربهم خوفا وطمعا ومما رزقناهم ينفقون, فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. أفمن كان مؤمنا كمن كان فاسقا
لا يستوون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى، فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى، الذي يصلى النار الكبرى، ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى، صحف إبراهيم وموسى.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله.
السلام عليكم. We're changing the Fajr from 5 o'clock to 5:15 inshallah from tomorrow. And same thing for Isha is going down to 9:30 from 9:45. We have a janazah today, if you guys can attend. And there's a janazah on Monday also. We need help in that because the brother doesn't have any family. All right, so if you can join on Monday too, that'll be great. Please make dua. There's a sister who's having a surgery in LA today. Please make dua for her. Let's go to give her a piece of our shahadah.
Thank you. الشيخ النشاوي صديق المشاهد وجاي بكرة ايرا عشرين وطلع سان فرانسيسكو وطلع على دالاس كمان لو حابين انا هاخده ورايحين على جاردن جروف ان شاء الله يوم الحد المغرب عشاء لو حابين نجيب ليلة نجيب الشيخ صديق المشاهد الشيخ المشاهد
هو ده قبل كده
كان معاه في رمضان ايوه لو حابين نجيب كليله ونعمل معانا ويقعد 20 يوم هنا الكليله بتاعته الله يا شيخ I was telling brother Ali